Hi, and welcome back to HVAC Talk, Let's Be Real. My name's Renee. I'm one of the owners of LCS. And today we're going to talk a little bit about a new to-do list during our time at home. So I've heard a lot of people say that their house has never been as clean as it is right now, or that they have their honey-do list complete, or that all their spring cleaning, garage is cleaned out, basement's cleaned out, everything's done. So now what to do? Well, I had a couple of ideas that I just wanted to share with you. These are things that sometimes we put off, and this is actually a perfect time now to get them done, or at least get them on the calendar. So of course, I'm gonna start number one with your air conditioner maintenance. So this is something that is often scheduled in May, June, July, any of those months is just fine. You can go ahead and get that scheduled right now. So our office is open, we're happy to get that on the calendar. If you'd like to get it done now, as long as the temperatures outside are warm enough, we're happy to do that. As we've mentioned before, we have a lot of precautions in place coming into your home. And with air conditioner maintenance, most of our work is done outside as well. So we're even working on a no contact air conditioner maintenance. So get your air conditioner maintenance at least on the schedule. So some other things that you can do right now too, this is a great time to get in touch with your financial advisor. So it's often recommended that you talk with that person anyway, every 6 months or once a year at least. And so if you haven't had that review lately, this is a great time to do that. An in-person meeting is not necessarily ideal, but those meetings can definitely be done over the phone or by a Zoom or Skype meeting as well. Next, we thought about taxes. And so even though there are some extensions with tax deadlines and things like that, your accountant will thank you if you go ahead and get all of your tax stuff to them sooner rather than later. So if you've not filed your taxes yet, use this time to gather that information and get that over to your accountant. Some other things that we thought of are insurance. So if you have life insurance policies and you've not updated your beneficiaries, or you've checked on that lately to even remember who your beneficiaries are on your life insurance policies, this is a great time to get in touch with your insurance agent and get that done. If you don't have life insurance policies in place, this is a great time to get with your agent and get some quotes on life insurance. Very, very important, and it's something that people often put off because they don't want to think about it or they don't have time. Along those lines, if you don't have an estate plan in place, this is a great time to talk to your attorney to get that done. There is a myth out there that you have to have a ton of money or a ton of real estate or a ton of whatever to have an estate plan, but really you don't. It's really necessary, you know, having a living will or having a plan for your children if something should happen to you. It's really important, and nobody likes to think about those things, but it's really important that those are in place, and this is a great time to talk to your attorney to get that done. I do believe that signatures need to be in person. However, maybe all the prep work could go ahead and be done as you are at home and getting information, and then you could finalize it once we can be together again. So some other thoughts that we had for small businesses, this is a great time to look at your benefits. And so what benefits do you offer? Have there been any other benefits that you've thought about offering but you need to get some more information on? This is some great time to contact those people and see if you can get some quotes or more information for benefits to offer your employees. So this might be health insurance, it might be supplemental insurance like Aflac or Colonial Life, it could be dental insurance, any of that good stuff. Speaking of dental, that reminded me, it's a great time to go ahead and get your eye appointments and your dental appointments on the calendar. So many times those are scheduled out in advance anyway, and so go ahead and get those on the calendar. Something that I did, haircuts are very important to me. I have short hair and I like to keep up on my haircuts. And so even though my hairstylist is not open right now, she has her calendar in front of her. And so I've reached out and I've gone ahead and scheduled my hair appointments for the next 6 months. So that way I know they're on the calendar and I don't have to worry about it once things return to probably what is going to be our new normal. So I hope that helps and gives you some ideas on what you can do during this time. It's often those things that we tend to push off because they're not urgent. We don't always realize how important it is until we need something like that. And It's just a time thing, or we forget about it. It's not always in front of us. So use this time. Those are just some ideas that we have. Travis and I are very fortunate to network and meet a lot of great people and business owners. So if you need a referral to any of those services that we mentioned, reach out, because we're happy to pass along the names and numbers of people that we know and trust. So, okay, hope you all are doing well out there, and we will look forward to talking to you again soon. Thanks so much for joining me on HVAC Talk, Let's Be Real, and I'll see you next week.